This image was generated using AI. So was this, and so were these. And this one won the prestigious Sony World Photography Awards. And nobody at Sony was able to detect that this was an image generated by AI. I mean, seriously, in the last 1 year, have you seen the increased amount of dependence that we have gotten on artificial intelligence? I mean, the tech world is filled with innovations like smartphones. But even that took some time to become big. Since the launch of the iPhone in 2007, till the time smartphones achieved mainstream, it took at least a few years. But that's not the case with AI. Especially generative AI. And that is tools like ChatGPT. In this, the AI tool is trained on a lot of existing sets of data using a model called the Large Language Model or an LLM. Based on all this information and learning, tools like ChatGPT answer our questions or write us essays, or sometimes even generate photographs that win awards that is meant for real photographers. Believe me, calling the growth of AI as extraordinary will still be an understatement. And here's the timeline. In November 2022, ChatGPT was launched by OpenAI. By November 2023, we have already seen the CEO of OpenAI, Sam Altman, being called in for a Senate hearing in the United States. Fake images of Donald Trump going viral, and the UK organizing a global summit regarding the safety of AI, where none other than the British Prime Minister Rishi Sunak interviewed Elon Musk talking about his views on AI. I mean, all of this happened within 1 year. And if that wasn't enough, we have recently seen Sam Altman getting fired as the CEO of OpenAI spectacularly, then getting rehired at Microsoft, then getting rehired back at OpenAI as CEO, and then he firing the entire board that fired him in the first place. All of this happened in less than a week. Man, this is fast. And like anything, generative AI does have a good side, a bad side, and an intriguing, questionable side. The bad side that we're supposed to be cautious about is obviously the misuse that can happen from the perspective of cybercrimes, but also from the perspective of mental health. Let me explain. You might have heard about deepfakes already. If you haven't, it's basically using AI to generate real-looking images or videos of people. Like this clip of Morgan Freeman.
I am not Morgan Freeman, and what you see is not real. Well, at least in contemporary terms, it is not. What if I were to tell you that I am not even a human being? Would you believe me?
Sounds real, doesn't it? But that's not all. You might have noticed iPhones now have this feature of cloning your voice to be used on Siri. You read a few lines of text, and then the iPhone replaces Siri's voice with your voice. Sounds fancy, but do you realize what will happen if this gets into the wrong hands? Just picture this. Someone has access to your phone, which has the contacts of everyone that you know and trust. And then an iPhone, which can actually talk in your voice. Now, if a call is placed to any of those people in your contact list using your voice, imagine the potential damage this can do. And this is just one aspect of it. But hey, I mentioned mental health too, right? That's because going further, we're gonna be having devices like the Vision Pro, which is an AR and VR headset, but merge that with generative AI tech available, and you may soon have a real person standing in front of you in the real world speaking in his or her real voice, when in reality, this person may or may not even exist. I mean, just imagine if someone lost someone really very close to them, but was able to arrange enough images and videos of that person and create an AR model of that person using all this data. And then add this generative AI tech into it where this person or an AR model is able to speak using their own voice. So in this sort of a scenario, you can interact with such a person using a device like Vision Pro, like have conversations with them, go out on dates with them and stuff like that. I mean, it kinda sounds a little bit weird to me, doesn't it? And how far do you think this can actually affect the mental health of people? And clearly such tech has gotten even tech leaders like Elon Musk and Bill Gates worried as well. who have earlier suggested to put a pause on the development of AI. But then there are other leaders too, like Eric Schmidt, the former CEO of Google, who says that stopping the development of AI will do more harm than good, as it will only give countries like China an advantage to take a lead in the AI race. But hey, that's just the potential bad side of generative AI. If used right, you can unlock a new level of productivity with it, and maybe even make a living out of it. You must have already heard people making money using AI-generated content, like publishing ebooks or generating YouTube channels and such. Not just that, even your daily tasks can be made simpler using AI, such as writing the perfect email or deciding what to cook and, you know, all these trivial questions that you don't want to answer on a daily basis. All of this can be outsourced to AI to get you the best possible result. And finally, we now move on to the intriguing, questionable side of generative AI. We all have seen the realistic art that is being generated by Midjourney and other AI tools. Now, artists are worried that this may result in their professions becoming obsolete. I just came across this platform that can generate a complete song in any style and genre with perfect vocals. So, clearly, artists are worried. But this is the classic chicken and egg problem here. Because all these artificial intelligence tools which generate art and music were trained on existing art and music which was created by humans for the last couple of decades or even a century. If AI manages to replace human artists, then there will definitely be a decline in people creating new styles of art and music, and this will lead to a reduction of the original work that is being created. So, if AI replaces human artists, what is the future AI gonna train itself on to create more art? That being said, job loss is something that people surely are worried about. But then we have new jobs coming in too, like prompt engineering. It's a fascinating job that has recently gotten into the picture that makes a six-digit salary. All of this is just scratching the surface and we are just getting started. What are your views on this? Do let me know in the comment section. If you've liked this video, hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.